Welcome. Thank you for the satsang, Bulavanaka. I love you all very much. There isn't anything you can do or attend to or put your attention on more important than what this kind of getting together represents. Anything that is the actual, not the theoretical, the philosophical, the conceptual, anything that's the actual meeting in truth, touching in truth, relating in truth, seeking out truth, wanting reality, grasping, searching, reaching for the divine, acknowledging the eternal and the infinite. There's nothing else that has any claim on the meaning or priority of a human life beyond that. That is the primary and the only reasonable, intelligent approach. Everything else is very, very tiny, very temporary, very short-sighted. It's not in conventional life, in everyday life, in the societal life, considered short-sighted to be concerned with all the moments between birth and death. But of course, that's the short-sighted view, because where were you before birth? Where will you be before death? After death, sorry. Well, and that applies too. Where will you be before death? Because what ordinary, everyday way of living does not want to acknowledge is that you were somewhere before birth. You were somewhere. You're going to be somewhere after death. You're not going to disappear. Something that is in you right now continues. Something that is in you right now existed before you were conceived. That's the long view. The short view is the 60, 70, 80, 90 years that you're inured in an experience of this bodily lifespan on this particular spinning rock. But the rest stretches out beginninglessly and endlessly. And even the simplest way of thinking tells us that the short view can't make sense. And we live in an era where the short view has become wildly popular. Wildly popular. It's not the first time in history, in the history of human societies and human approaches to life, that the short view has become more popular than the long view. But everyone does better when the long view prevails. Everyone does better when the short view is seen for the short-sighted aspect that it primarily consists of. Make a big profit right away, but don't think about the long term. That's why the financial markets have become so dangerous. That's why great fortunes have been made like never before in history, and these are always teetering on the edge because the long view is not part of how people think when this becomes dominant. And like everything else beyond 1950, it's traceable back to Ronald Reagan. The long view prevailed until Reagan took office. Then he immediately ushered in the short view. Short-term, quick, maximized profit became the way of doing things. All the shortcuts. And anyone who has studied life closely, who has looked at their own experience, has observed others, has come to the conclusion, if you haven't, you can just accept that it's the correct conclusion, that shortcuts are always, always without fail, the long cut. Shortcuts are always problematic. They always make you trip over your own feet. And in the end, it takes much longer and the gains are less when you do it through shortcuts. Everybody thinks in general that shortcuts are possible. But on this planet, maybe somewhere else, but on this planet, no shortcut is possible. What looks like a shortcut is self-deception. It skips over that which makes a foundation so we can move smoothly and hold on to whatever we gain so that what is garnered can be kept and maintained. And we live in an era when this has become, of course, the same idea in spiritual life. The whole New Age movement is about shortcuts, spiritual shortcuts. Don't actually take on the challenges of spiritual life. Don't actually take on the arduousness of treading the spiritual path. Do a little of this, a little of that. Recite some hocus pocus. Have positive thinking, which is neither positive nor thinking. And you have the shortcut, which goes nowhere. New Age only leads to one thing. Doesn't lead to truth, doesn't lead to God. New Age only leads to one thing. Old age. With nothing to show for it, nothing of an eternal understanding to show for it. So if you're a New Ager, cure yourself. Take the long view. Don't look for shortcuts in life and don't look for shortcuts to God. There aren't any. There appear to be always, but they're never a good idea because they always have pitfalls. They always make you go in circles and they always take longer. The irony of shortcuts is they're the long way. The irony of taking the long way is it's the closest thing to a shortcut. Because it actually goes somewhere and actually has a chance of getting you there if you persist. So even in life, I strongly encourage you to avoid shortcuts because you get a lot of encouragement and a lot of suggestion to an influence to take the shortcut, get around something, cut the corner. And you teach yourself, when you do this, you teach yourself that that is a good habit. It develops into a habit so that you choose the shortcut kind of automatically. And that's very self-defeating. Shortcut is the road to self-defeating. Long cut, regular way, is the only way that ever has a chance to work. So whatever it is, don't rail against the regular way. Don't be resentful that you have to do it the way everybody has to do it. Don't try to be the exception. Don't try to be the one who gets there first because you did the shortcut. You won't get there first. You're much more likely to get there last. And even if the shortcut gets you there first, It's an illusion. You'll pay for it later. You'll lose more later, so that whatever you gain will be lost and more. So I'm very anti-shortcut, pretty much across the board. I haven't seen a shortcut yet that actually was a shortcut. So it's kind of a false concept.